very important. So if you don't want to do all this processing, the simple way is to eat only fruits. Basically, we are meant to eat fruits.
Sir, so it's very simple. You know, they say milk was not for us, it was for the calf. And now you say grains were also not for us, but for the birds.
Yes.
The only fruits were made for us.
Yes, because grains we have to cook and eat. Na?
Correct.
So, amongst the dals and all, it is only besan, for making besan only we can ferment it, rest we have.
No, actually every dal has to be See, basically why I didn't tell not to ferment dal, if you want to cook it soft, it will not cook soft.
Right.
But still, you can eat them. Right. It will be like cooked grains, it will be, the texture will be hard.
Right.
But we have the practice to eat like finely mashed dal, na?
Mm.
That texture will not come if it ferments.
Right, but it is still better.
That is good, yeah. If you don't want to eat that, what you call that liquid consistency dal,
right,
you can ferment it and then cook it. You need not make it into fine, soft one. It will get cooked, you can eat it. It will be like chaat, like those dal, you can add vegetables and make a like chaat and you can eat. But if you want to have like dal for your rice and all, then it will not happen. Oils. So, our body actually doesn't, like it needs fats, fatty acids, which we get from fruits. But from the oil seeds, that oil which we are using are refined oils. They use a lot of chemicals, hexane and many solvents to extract the oils. And they use mineral oil, which is petroleum oil, as an additive. So that is very harmful. And also they add palm oil, which is also not good for us. Coconut seed oil. They will mix anything with whichever they get cheap in the market. And in refining, you will not get any of its aroma. In fact, they will add whatever aroma you want. Like if you want sunflower smell, sesame smell, they will add fragments into it. So these all adulterations are happening. So even if you want to have oils, it should be cold press oils. That is very important. And also cold press oils, we are taking cold press oils, and again if you are heating the oil, there is no point. So basically we should not use oils for cooking. We can season the oils. So after cooking, like you can use water for cooking basically. So masalas will not get mixed in the oil. Basically it needs some liquid medium. We are adding oil for that. It's not required. So it needs heat to bring the aroma. So we can also use water as a medium. And we can steam our vegetables or add little water and cook our vegetables. In the last, you can spread the cold press oil, it may be mustard oil or sesame oil, whatever oils you are using, cold press oils, you can season it in the last. That's how it is better. The more better is soak the peanuts or sesame, remove the water, because outside they don't do this process. So if you just soak the seeds, oil seeds, and remove the water and make the paste and add into your vegetables, it will be more better because you'll have that fibers and the
coconut
whole thing you'll have.
Coconuts are, is it okay?
Coconuts are
superfood and fat.
See, again, coconuts are not meant for us. So coconut is not like a fruit, like apple or whatever fruit we are eating. So it has a very hard shell, we have to break it open. Basically our food is a fruit which we can eat with our hand. We should not require any tools. But yeah, then what is the purpose of coconuts? They are actually windbreakers. So for the seas, they are very high winds from the seas. To break that winds, these coconut trees will help. So basically the purpose of coconut tree is to serve as a windbreaker. So then why the coconut fruits are coming? It has to propagate, it has to multiply. So there may be other species who can consume it. Even we can consume the tender coconut. Like if you see that coconut, like if you open that water, we can drink. It will be very tender. Even monkeys will drink the coconut water. But if it is getting matured, basically it is forming into a seed. The fibers are very hard. Even if you eat that coconut, it will be very hard. But we use mixy to make it fine and then we will try to push. So that will be insoluble fibers. Insoluble fibers, which is hard for the system. But we want to push it. So if you want to get the benefit of it, so take the milk, ferment it, make curd or buttermilk and have, or consume tender coconut, which is very soft.
About this coconut lassi also we can make using this tired ground chili?
Yes.
Chili crown.
Yes. You can't even differentiate between your normal buttermilk. Normal lassi. It will be same like a lassi.
So you just take out the coconut milk, you add chili crowns, nothing, it's mustard seeds. And no salt.
Whatever flavors, salt you can add. Adrak.
During the flavoring time,
first only.
So you're saying that coconut milk one can take. That's what you said?
Coconut milk directly we can't take. Again, it will not digest. We have to ferment it. Or eat chutney. Like when you're blending the coconut chutney and eating, that is fine.
If you put peanuts into it.
Little, whatever chutneys you make. Because you are using external.
So you mean to say what, it should not be taken raw?
Coconut raw, even if you take, what I do is, I eat the coconut, chew the juice, because while chewing, my saliva will get mixed, I can digest from here, digestion will happen from here only.
Yeah, like
I'll remove the fiber.
Okay. And throw it through it.
I'll put for my plants. It's not wasting it anywhere. It's again utilized. Or I can use it as a scrub.
Yeah, like sir, you mentioned about the heating oils, you know, we should not heat it, you correctly said.
Yeah.
Like there is a practice, in, especially in Punjab, we take sarso ka tel, that mustard oil, and then we heat it to the smoking point.
Yeah.
Then and then we put the vegetables.
Yeah.
That's a absolutely wrong
thing.
So in a realistic manner, when we use this mustard oil, so should we like, you know, put it on the gas and not heat it?
So there is a temperature,
take it to the
smoking
point.
So mild
just heat it a little bit and start,
that is fine.
Start, you know, making the vegetable.
Yeah,
I think that
fine. Still, the nutrient values will be lost while heating.
It will be, yes.
So if you want to get the benefit of, complete benefit of it, don't heat the oil. Add the oil in the last. Then how to cook the seeds? Just heat is enough. Like heat the pan, add your mustard, zira, whatever you want. Dry roast them.
Yeah, and there are utensils available wherein you can make the vegetables with water. There are utensils available in market these
without
days.
Without water?
If you can make the sabzis and everything with water. And you take put the oil later on, the way you said.
With water or without water?
With water.
With water anyway we can make.
Anyway, but there are specific.
Without water there are utensils, they are, we have discussed.
Okay.
Those are called AMC, some brands are there, surgical steel,
yes.
6th grade. Without
MA
water,
has got
can.
This queen,
Amway, yes.
queen, they have got this queen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we talked about the containers, we can look.
Okay, great.
So this is about oil, so it should be cold press oil. So better is use whole of the oil seed, but so can make the paste and use, that's a better. You can also make ghee from oils, like from oil seeds. Like ghee is not cow ghee or buffalo ghee. Basically, the process of making the ghee is called ghrut. So that final product is ghee. So even if you make from coconut milk, the virgin coconut oil, whatever you're calling, is actually ghee. The same way you can make peanut, sesame, whatever oil seeds are there, take the milk, curdle it, churn the butter and heat it, or instead of heating, can keep under sun, the oils will come out and you can separate that oils. So that is ghee, peanut ghee or whatever ghee you call it.
Can you give us more details about this process?
So you have to soak the peanuts. Suppose you are making from peanuts, soak the peanuts, remove the water, but you have to wash the peanuts because peanuts will leave bitterness. So wash the peanuts, then make it into fine paste, blend the milk. So you get the thicker milk. So in that you can add the chili crumbs to ferment to make peanut curd. Then churn it to get the peanut butter. Like how you get the milk butter, you get the peanut butter. Then that can be heated to make oil or kept in sun also to get the oil.
उसको हम गर्म कर सकते हैं जो आप बोल रहे हैं मक्खन निकलेगा मक्खन को गर्म करके हम तेल बना
डबल बॉइलिंग करना
मिल्क
एक्चुअली फॉर 6 to 8 hours दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बट नाउ ऑलरेडी द मिल्क इज पैश्चराइज सो ओके वॉट एवर
If we're getting raw, say,
So we have to boil the milk,
yes.
Then curdle it, make the curd, then churn it, then remove the butter. And this is buttermilk. So that butter we can heat or keep under sun. It will release the oils.
So I'm going wrong in the first stage.
So what
I
you do is
remove the cream.
Cream. Then you heat it.
Yes.
Huh. So what you can do is after removing the malai, you ferment it. Then
add dahi to it.
Add dahi to it.
Okay.
Then churn it. So you'll get the concentrated butter.
तो जब हम सन में रखेंगे उसका अप्रोक्सीमेट कितना टाइम होता है उसका मतलब घी बनने में अगर हम बॉईल नहीं करना चाहते
हाँ बॉईल नहीं करें तो अच्छा है सो सन में और टेम्परेचर के हिसाब से सो एक कंटेनर उसमें रख के कपड़ा ग्लास का प्लेट ऐसा रख के रख दीजिए
ठीक है
और टेम्परेचर से ऑलरेडी लाइक हीटिंग होता है ना ऑयल सेपरेट होते हैं उसका
मतलब 4-5 घंटे में हो जाएगा कि ज्यादा
लगेगा मे बी 6 आवर्स एक दिन पूरा
जैसे सपोज करो एक दिन में नहीं हुआ अभी सर्दी का टाइम है तो एक दिन में उसको रख दिया फिर अगले दिन रखा
थोड़ा खट्टा होता ना उसमें फिर भी आएगा ऑयल्स आएगा सन में नहीं रखे तो भी ऑयल्स आ जाएगा थोड़ा ज्यादा टाइम लगता
मतलब खराब नहीं होता
है क्यों बोलते आपको ऑयल सेपरेट हो जाता
जो ऑयल निकल गया और जो बाकी जो बच गया दैट इज वेस्ट
नो दैट इज ऑल्सो वे प्रोटीन इवन वो भी पी सकते
ओके
हाँ मगर इसमें ना आपको एक ग्लास कोनिकल सेपरेटर बोल के लैब में मिलता जिसमें ए शेप में रहता वी शेप में सो वो क्रीम और पानी अलग हो जाता तो वो आप नोजल ओपन करे तो पानी जो नीचे सेटल होता क्रीम ऊपर सेटल हो जाता पानी नीचे आता तो जब नोजल ओपन करते ना ये पानी बाहर आ जाते वो क्रीम आप सेपरेट रख सकते जल्दी होता नहीं तो पानी ज्यादा है तो वो फिर खराब हो सकता और ज्यादा टाइम भी लगता एवापोरेशन के लिए तो खाली वो कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड जो क्रीम है वो फर्मेंटेड क्रीम है बटर है वो आप सन में रखे तो जली हो जाता वो वाटर ज्यादा नहीं रहता ना वैसा
फिर तो उस गैस वाला ठीक है वो स्लो
हाँ इसलिए डबल बॉइलिंग में हीट करके उसमें उसमें उतना नष्ट नहीं है डबल बॉइलिंग करके कर सकते सोख करके पानी निकालने का प्रोसेस है और
सिसमे
भी कर सकते सिसमे में बहुत कम आएगा ऑयल मात्रा पीनट्स में ऑयल ज्यादा रहता फिर भी जितना ऑयल है वो तो निकलेगा
जो बोल ड्रिवन रहता है जिसको बोलते
वो अच्छा है लाइक वो सनड्राई करके मगर एक्चुअली ना वही अभी बोल ड्रिवन है और एक इलेक्ट्रिकल मोटर से लो आरपीएम से कच्चा गनी है वो भी ठीक है तो वो ऑयल जब आता ना वो फ्रेश ऑयल खाए तो बहुत अच्छा रहता मगर ऐसा रख दिए तो ऑक्सीडेशन हो जाता वो खराब
कितनी देर में ऑक्सीडेशन होएगा उसका उस ऑयल का अगर जैसे सपोज करो एक महीना पहले
एक
महीने के अंदर यूज कर
सकते तो इसलिए क्या करते हैं ऑक्सीडेशन नहीं होने के लिए उन लोग एक फिल्टर्स रहता क्लॉथ फिल्टर्स लगाते उसमें वो ऑयल को पास करे तो वो उसमें जो सॉल्युबल फाइबर्स रहता फाइन वो सेपरेट होके क्लियर ऑयल सेपरेट होता वो क्या होता ऑक्सीडेशन लाइक इट विल टेक प्रोलॉन्ग्ड लाइक ज्यादा शेल्फ लाइफ रहता सो फिर भी ना आप ऑयल जब पुराना टाइम में क्या करते थे ऑयल लाए तो भी बड़े कंटेनर में ऑयल को स्टोर करके डेली ओपन नहीं करते लाइक इतने टाइम ओपन करते हवा जितना बार जाता ना उतना जल्दी खराब हो जाता तो वीकली के लिए अलग कंटेनर रहता डेली के लिए अलग कंटेनर रहता ऐसा प्रैक्टिस था ताकि ऑयल खराब नहीं होता तो अभी तो पैकेट्स लेके आते वो अलग बात है 1 लीटर बॉटल्स इजी आ जाता और ऑयल कभी भी प्लास्टिक बॉटल्स में स्टोर नहीं करना वो इम्पोर्टेंट है वो प्लास्टिक लीच होता ग्लास बॉटल में ही रहना चाहिए नहीं तो स्टील और
जैसे भी वो बैम्बू बॉटल्स आ गई बैम्बू वो आ रहे हैं तो उसको भी स्टोर कर सकते
हैं बैम्बू में चेक करना क्यों बोलते हो फंगस आने का चांस है तो मैं बैम्बू में
व्हाट अबाउट स्टील
स्टील ओके ग्लास इज बेटर
ग्लास इज बेटर
सिरेमिक ग्लास वो सब अच्छा उसके बाद